Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to our broadcast of the E-League GameStar Spring Series, our Overwatch qualifier number one. We've had a number of tech issues through the day, and it's because we're trying some new overlays, trying some new technology to try and up our production value for when the first division season starts. So apologize once again for taking it down. But hopefully through our stumbles and falls through today, we'll be able to get the regular season going without any issues at all. So thanks for bearing with us. My name is Crisis, and I'm going to step back right now and hand over to Bobby J, who's going to lead us into the next game.
Thank you very much, Crisis. We're just looking at the leaderboard right now with Jam, Aftermind, and Kicked or Get Kicked in HKS rounding out the top four with a 4-0 for Jam and 3-1 for the other three teams. But here we've got Creators of the Meme Museum, and we've got, okay, now I'm just drawing a blank, guys. HKS, sorry, our Army Kebab Shop here on the left-hand side. You're up first, Xenox. What do you think? What do you think's going to happen with these two teams clash here?
Look, honestly, HKS for me is definitely the favorite going into this game. I know for a fact that obviously Curators of the Meme Museum newly created. They probably, I know they've scrimmed, but they are very much new to the, you know, tournament formats and as a team as a whole. So going into this one on Anubis, it definitely for me, HKS.
And what about you, Gaima?
Yeah, I think both of these teams, they've had a bit of shuffling lately. For example, HKS has picked up Slit, who we remember from Queen Team as being a really strong player, but it's added in players. Yes, they raise the skill level of a team, but they hurt some of that experience advantage. We've talked about this previously today, and that may close the team's gap in terms of experience of playing together, and I think either of these teams can win.
What about you, OG?
Yeah, as I said previously, both these teams are fairly new to me, but I do remember the players such as Lush and Slidzor, as we were saying, from Quentium. But it will be interesting to see, especially on a double capture point map here on the Assault on Temple of Anubis, to see how both these teams sort of come up against each other in a sort of unique sort of game type.
And then before we head in, Geodome, what are your predictions between these two teams?
Now, I might just slightly give it to HKS here. I'm going to be very interested to see how Lush goes and even just what role he picks, because he was a very strong DPS player who then went on to support when he joined Tempo Storm, just, you know, purely off the strength of their roster. So very interesting to see what he plays. And yeah, it's great to see Slidzor back in the mix as well.
And I'm going to throw it over here for round five. Back to Xenox. It's going to be Xenox and Geonome taking away this game. So take it away, Xenox.
Thanks a lot, Bobby. So round five, it's Anubis. We've got Curators of the Museum. And of course, we've got HKS, formerly known as Harambe Kebab Shop, or still known as Harambe Kebab Shop, whichever they have chosen for the day. Gino, welcome, of course, for today, the analyst. And, you know, we got a good game here. We're on Anubis now. It's our first assault, and it's back into the pool now.
Yeah, thanks, Xenox. And wow, so we've got Lush on the McCree here. I guess on a team like this, you know, with his aim, we should expect him to be on the hitscan characters. And, you know, he's going to be bringing all that experience he got from Tempo Storm, all the strategies he learned there. And, you know, I've heard Radek talk about preparing for 2CP, having a look at the international tournament scene and seeing that they were using the 2CP maps. So maybe some of that experience is going to come along to HKS with Lush.
Yeah, definitely. So we're seeing, obviously, HKS here on defense. I got the Junkrat with Slidzor, which is really interesting to see. I think it can work. I think Junkrat's a little bit underrated in the past. We've obviously not really seen him a lot in that competitive play, but he is sometimes used, you know, I guess, not
so good on the choke points here.
Yeah, extremely good on these choke points, especially on maps like these assault maps. It's going to be charging immediately, Chef, on that Genji, trying to get her into that back line as it's going to be Tyradin jumping in with the Winston. But Lush had already taken down Giroff, and now Slidzor taking down Tyradin. So that really capitulated as soon as it happened. They just kind of came in a little bit scattered. One went to the right, one went to the back, and then they both died.
Yeah, really interesting. So usually a team will just speed boost through the point here and try and go left or right, either way, and just keep as a punch. But they seem to just go all around, try and make some space for Shrandy to get a pick on that Widowmaker, but didn't work out at all. They all just got picked by the nice clump of HKS.
Well, they're going to be very vital for Shranny to get that early pick off on that Widowmaker. He's up on the balcony now. Doc Zanata, though, taking down Jeff on that Kenji again, falling down. But Shranny taking down Doc Zanata. It doesn't matter, though, because Lush has gotten a double kill onto Numkey and Compose. And HKS holding really strongly right now. And Shranny's moved up really aggressively. He could be in a bad position. He's going to have to try and climb away. But Hobbs takes him down. He also took down Tyroden. Hobbs getting those kills on that Lucio.
Yeah, so they've tried the same thing, exactly the same again, and it just hasn't worked out. I think they really need to stick with that, the death ball blob. I don't know, maybe they need to change up character there. Lush, oh my god, hitting the headshots. Like, I think there was 4 shots in a row there. He just didn't miss. Just crazy aim.
Yeah, and on these assault maps, especially, you know, if you don't get those first couple of pushes, the pressure starts to come on. It's 2 minutes and 20 seconds to go now, as the Riptide's going to come out and take down Compose. I don't think he was expecting that one right in his face. And Tyron pops the Monkey Ultimate. Can he take down Dr. Nutter in that corner? He finally goes down thanks to health and armor. Is this now the chance for Curators to get onto the point? But Lush had already taken down Tyron, and now they're going to get the Earthshatter coming out from Huss, trying to take down this Geoff. On the Genji, the fire at will, the Graviton Surge comes out, but it's immediately countered by the Tranquility. Shranny had picked up a double kill onto Hobbs and Lush as well. Is this going to be enough for them, though, as Funky's come back? Huss is in their face with that shield. Armor, though, in the back line, they take down Slushaw. Armor then takes down Huss, and finally, Genome, they've got this first point at a minute 45.
Wow, Funky, yeah, he's Transcendence there. I thought that was going to save them, but Armor throwing out great bubbles. The timing on them was just mint. Every time a bubble went down, that was the player that was being focused by HKS, and it was giving him extra charge and keeping that player alive.
So Shranny had already moved up on that Widowmaker to try and get an early pick off. Obviously, though, the shield from Huss is going to stop most of that damage, but you can just see they're going to move in really quickly here. That's kind of the flow of these assault maps. You get that first point, then you want to move straight away onto that second point, regardless of your ultimate percentage or anything like that. They have got a couple of ultimates, though. They have got the Dragon Blade up, as well as the Tranquility and Sound Barrier. So they've definitely got a bit of a potential here. Maybe, though, they might wait for the Graviton Surge to come out, but this would be a perfect time as HKS have nothing to counter.
Yeah, they're taking quite a while to come in here. They've got the support ults if they really want to push in and use them. And here we go, that's the drop beat.
Numkey bops that Lucio Soundbarrow as Tyrant and over taking out Huss. The Graviton Surge has come out. It doesn't matter though, Shrini are taking down Dr. Nutter. Jeff gets the double kill onto Lush and Funky, and they've absolutely turned this one right around, getting onto this second point rather quickly now, getting it with 4 minutes and 30 seconds to go. Can they cap it though? Getting this second point now, they've got the first bit. Numkey taking down Hobbs. They're just getting them as they come back in. Dr. Nutter having to switch down to the Tracer just to get back onto the point quickly. It doesn't matter. And there's the Earthshatter from Tyrant, and they're going to take down Dr. Nutter. They're getting all the kills as Compo's got a double kill on that Zenyatta, taking down Dr. Nutter. Hobbs, Slushaw, they just continue to fall. It's HKS. They're dead, and they've lost this first round.
So they waited until they had exactly the ults they wanted to push in there. They had their the beat drop from the Lucio allowed them to push in, make some space. They had the Transcendence ready for any other ults that HKS were going to use against them. And then they had the Dragon Blade to initiate the fight and get those first couple of picks. They executed that second point entrance so beautifully. If you get stuck, and the defending team gets an ult advantage in the second point of Anubis, it can be horrible to attack into, and you just waste so much time. So maybe just taking an extra 30 seconds or a minute there to make sure that first push works, I think in the long run, absolutely the right decision. Well done, Curators.
And it puts the pressure now onto HKS, because not just in this game, but on the standings, they're actually tied second with Aftermind and Kicked or Get Kicked on 3-1. Obviously, we know the top three go through from today. If they lose this game, they could actually fall out of that top three bracket on the standings. So they really have to get this win over Curators, who are sitting down the bottom at 1-3. This could be a massive upset.
Yeah, and I think it's still anybody's game. They have definitely got the skills to take it out. They are going with a Junkrat, sorry. So, and I think Junkrat is one of those characters where if you really get on a roll with him, you punch out the damage as they're pushing through those tight chokes, you can definitely hold them on first. So, we'll see what happens.
Yeah, It's always interesting, these assault maps. You know, 4 minutes and 9 seconds, though, is a really, really good time. I think Curators would be extremely happy with that push. Maybe took a little bit too long with that second point. They could have pushed in almost immediately if they really wanted to, but you know what? You can't fault something that worked. Credit to them. They ended up getting the point, so now they've got to defend here. Can they at least stop this first point for quite a while and put the pressure really on top of HKS? I guess that's what we're going to be interesting to see. And the other interesting to see is Jeff actually on that Junkrat as well. So he's countering sort of what Slizjaw did in that first round. And of course, Slippery Slid is on that Genji as Lush went down really early on that Tracer. And Genome, obviously, we know with these sort of maps, if you don't get that first couple of pushes, there's not much time.
Well, yes. And the Tracer is definitely an interesting pick here on the attack on Nubiswash. Randy just taking down Slidjaws, who was hiding up in a little window up the top there. That's going to be another 20 seconds for a reset. But yeah, you know, obviously Tracer's such a low health hero, getting picked up by two Junkrat grenades and boom, you're gone.
Yeah, we haven't really seen any sort of fast push simply because they just keep getting that pick. There comes the push now from Huss, jumping right onto them, trying to scatter them. But Huss got down immediately. Slizzle trying to get into the back line, trying to take down Geofon. But Funky, the Zenyatta, he gets the double kill on the Composed and Tyranidan. The chance now for HKS to get onto this point. Armor's in a really, really tough spot at the moment and falls down to Slizzle. And this is now a massive chance for HKS to get this point. Although Jess just completely turned it around. He's got the double kill on the Hobbs and Slizzle. Although that can't be sustained. Finally falls down to Dr. Nutter, who turns it around for his team. And in the end, actually a pretty good time for HKS. They'd be pretty happy with that push.
Yeah, I thought Curators were going to hold there. Geoff getting a couple of nice picks with the Junkrat, and Shrandy was doing so much damage. When you get a nice high position like that on Soldier, all your bullets start going into their heads, and you will output a lot of damage. But I think the Junkrat might have just charged up Dr. Nutter too much, and the Zarya really won them that first point. They're staying alive and just cleaning up the last couple.
Well, now they've got an absolute massive time bank in their advantage. The pressure's off for a little while. There's no real stress at the moment. And because of that, they're pushing straight in. Huss has already taken down Compost, has Lost took down Tyrant and the Graviton Surge as well. They're absolutely wiping them. Dr. Nutter takes down Numkey. This is an absolute demolition with 6 minutes on the clock. They could just about take this point already. Nutter taking down Shrandy, Lush taking down Armor. They're just coming back into stalling for as long as they can. Tyrant, that was a really good charge though, trying to get Huss onto the pin, but he got him, but he died anyway. It didn't matter. Breaking it down is Numkey, immediately countered by Hobbs on his Lucio as Huss took down Compos. Lush now also onto Numkey. Dr. Nutter, oh, they're just coming in and dying with 5 minutes and 38 seconds. This is an absolute stall phase. Armor popping the Graviton Surge. He's got to get back into the point though. He just kind of left off, went off for a few seconds. The Earthshatter coming out now from Tyranid to turn this one around. Huss, he gets taken down thanks to the Discord. They might actually be able to save this one miraculously as Compos took down Lush. And finally, Curators are going to be able to stay on this point and actually get a pretty decent time now.
That was a pretty protracted battle there. And with the new 10-second spawn time, these second CP points are very hard to capture. They've got two ticks on the board, so at least next time they cap it, they don't have to hold on for too long. They just need to get a nice clean team wipe so that they can't come out and just like stagger it one by one with a D.Va or a Mei or whatever.
Yeah, well, the good thing, I guess, for HKS, they have got the two pips on that capture, so they really only need a team wipe, and then that's it. There shouldn't be a stalling phase after that because they won't have to, I guess, wait such a long time for the meter to fill up. The Graviton Surge comes out immediately, countered by the Tranquility from both Tranquilities coming out immediately from the Zenyattas, as Lizzo had already taken down Strandy, and the Earthshatter comes out now. Oh, they completely wiped him! Slippery Slid, he takes down Numkey, he takes down Neil. They're gonna get the kills as Compost took down Husk, but it doesn't matter. They've got the wipe, they've got the point. 4 minutes and 23 seconds, Jeno. It's a pretty good time for both teams. It's really even right now.
Yeah, so capping that first point a bit faster, but then taking the extra push to get the second point, ending up pretty much even there at 2-2. I wonder how many points this is going to go up to.
And just a word, guys. I'm not sure if you noticed, but for the first part of that second push, it looked like Slidzor was having issues. He stood behind a wall for ages, so they almost capped that first point, that second point on the first push with five players versus six. And it was only when Slidjaw seemed to sort out his issues and start moving around again that they were able to finally get that cap.
Oh, okay, wow. So then Dr. Nutter, even more impressive then. He was really taking them on his back to get that first point.
Yeah, definitely. I quite honestly didn't pick that one up. Slizzle obviously started the game, and so he was there, and then obviously those issues must have arisen. So a really good effort from them. 4 minutes and 9 seconds now, of course, for Curators. They're going to have to have a better first push than what they did last time, I think. And now we've seen no Junkrat coming out from Slizzle this time. That he's not mucking around. They're going with the three tanks on defense. This to probably try and stall as much time as they can, Geno.
Yeah, they haven't gone the full 3-3. They haven't got Anna. They've still got Lush on the McCree, which I think is the right choice because he is clicking heads with the best of them today. Let's see how far HKS can go in this second attack.
So, gonna just slowly walk in behind that shield. They got GF on that Pharah. Will he fly up or is he gonna go with him? He looks like he's gonna go with him through the building. Slizzle. Oh, he's gone right behind them. He could have actually jumped right on top of them had he noticed which way they were going, as GF has already taken down Funky. But it's a nice counter kill as Lush took down GF, so immediately getting a pick onto the DPS. Compose also had fallen down as well, thanks to Husk on that run hunt. And then he takes down Tyrant, and this is all going right for HKS at the moment. And this push is gonna get sent back to spawn.
Yeah, Mercy's still hiding up in this top building here, but she hasn't built up enough to get her resurrection yet. If she had done that, maybe they'd have a chance to push the curators off there, but it doesn't look like it's going to happen. They're trickling in here, and I think they're going to get pushed out.
Yeah, very scattered. I mean, they had a couple alive, no doubt they did. But then they were in a really bad position and they looked like they were going to be dying. And then some of their team, like Tyrant, just kind of walked in on the point thinking the fight was still going, when in fact there was no real advantage for him to come back in. He wasn't going to turn that fight around. Interesting to note though, Husk did waste his Earth Shatter up in that building, so that could be a turning point. If they can have that sort of team fight 6v6, they're going to have that advantage by having the Earth Shatter up on Tyrant and for Curators. So they've just got to group back up again and try this one more time. They're breaking it down as Lizzo gets a double kill on that win. And it doesn't matter if he's a tank or a DPS, he's gonna get those kills. Husk taking down armor, and geez, that was counted really, really quickly. 2 minutes and 30 seconds to go. HKS, well, whatever issues they had with that first round, they've turned it back on here and defending really well.
Yeah, so Lush popping his dead eye there, doesn't get any as they walk up on the right side. I think when you're going on that right side, you really need to either speed boost all the way and commit coming down all the way to the point, or just take the fight straight to them. And they're sort of just dilly-dallying around in the middle and it's not working out for them.
So they're going to try the right side strat now, coming in from the temple, but the Graviton turns from both sides come out. The Tranquility is going to try and stop most of that damage thanks to Composed. Funky still actually has his Tranquility. He pops it down. Trini is taking down Hobbs though. Can they get the kills? Duck to Nutter. He takes down Armor. This is an absolute massive brawl on top of this block of land. It's just all gone the way of Slush. A minute 30 to go. Well, that was absolutely awful for Curators. They popped a lot of ultimates there. They did actually have the revive from Numki, but he couldn't get it off, obviously.
Yeah, I love Funky's Transcendence there. As Zenyatta, it's a bit of a mind game. It's almost like the Ryan v. Ryan mind game, where you've got to know when that Earth Shatter is coming out, because if you're in Transcendence, it doesn't affect you. So he pops it just before the Earth Shatter comes out, and then he is able to save all of his teammates who are knocked down and disabled by it.
Yeah, very, very nicely done by Funky, holding it there when really he didn't need to use it, thanks to the Graviton Surge stopping the other team as well. So they were kind of in defensive mode, so I thought I can wait a few seconds here as Slizzle just sneakily in the back line. Husk and Tyrant are going to completely collide. Oh, there, Husk with the Earth Shatter. Does he get any kills? In fact, he doesn't. Ashrani took him down. Oh, Geob gets the double kill thanks to the Death Blossom. Funky taking down Geob. Numki's going to get the revive. This is a massive chance now for Curators to get back into this game. And finally, they take down Dr. Nutter as well as Funky. And they're going to get this point, Genome, with 35 seconds left. It was so close, but they've managed it, and at least they're not going to have to, I guess, defend the entire 4 minutes on the first point.
Yeah, so some of them got knocked off the bridge there, and as a result, the Earth Shatter only got one person in the end. I'm not sure if they got booped off by Hobbs or what happened there, but it did work out for them. And Dwarf goes in with a risky Death Blossom there. He was at the front, he was exposed, but he got two kills with it.
This is going to be really difficult, actually, though, because Q-Riders don't have a single ultimate. They might have the Earth Shatter soon, is at 92% for Tyranid, but with 34 seconds to go, they essentially have one push here. They have one good solid push, and that's about it. Solusia actually now just sneakily with the Mei, going to block them all off, and they take down Tyranid, and the one person who just about had his ultimate. This is a disaster at the moment now. Of course, this is just about over. 18 seconds. What a Mei wall from Solusia. He was being sneaky there. They didn't expect it. And that just completely stopped whatever they were trying to do. There's not much else to say, Gino. That was something they didn't expect, and they got caught out.
It would have been very hard for them to make anything work there. Maybe if they had have tried something like, you know, getting the Tyranid to take a little bit of damage with armor and boost Numki's revive up really quickly so that they could win that way. But yeah, going in with no ultimates, you either need to make something very special happen, get a revive, maybe Shrandy, you know, if he hits a bunch of headshots in a row, they could win out. But yeah, very tough situation coming in there. That said, 4 minutes to defend the first point, it's definitely doable. What do you think, Xanox?
Well, I mean, it is doable because of the fact that HKS almost did it. You know, it was 30 seconds that when Q-Riders caught it. And I think, in a way, if they can kind of do the same thing, it gives Q-Riders a chance to at least, you know, tie this up. Worst case scenario, you know, you get a couple of minutes on that second point, which can be pretty difficult to capture anyway. But if this first point does get steamrolled within probably, say, a minute or so, Geno, this could be very, very difficult to hold that second point, because we did see how well HKS just kind of steamrolled on that second point last round.
Yep, totally agree. This first push is going to be all important. If they don't get it in the first push, then, you know, maybe they'll be holding out for the tie, but I wouldn't expect them to get the second point if they can't clean up the first one pretty quickly here. And Slidsjaw, is he actually playing? Nah, he is. He's trolling us. Okay, he's on the Genji.
He needs to go on that Genji. He knows he needs to go on that Genji. His team does. 4 minutes and 18 seconds. That is the task in front of HKS right now. The first point is needed 100%. The second point will get them the win. And we are underway. They're just going to charge straight through. Splash gets the double kill immediately. Oh, this is going to be a disaster for Q-Raiders. This is not what they wanted. Already under the point. Tyranid has to charge back. He's got the Discord on him, though. He's surely going to fall down rather quickly. He does. Dr. Nunny gets the kill. This is an absolute... Oh, this is so bad for Q-Raiders. They absolutely just walked through, got the kills, took the point, and said, all right, see you at the next point.
Lush is on fire today, just completely opening it up with those two kills there. And now they've got 4 minutes, so that was what, to take the second point. So, hard
4 minutes
and very hard for the Q-Raiders.
This is going to be incredibly difficult to force the tiebreaker in a way. But I guess now the pressure's off from HKS. They're either going to win or they're going to tie. Shrandy took down Huss. That should slow them down slightly. But geez, 3 minutes and 50 seconds, you know, and this is going to be a really, really long battle.
Yeah, Shrandy obviously knows this map well enough because he's managed to get up on top of the pillar here as Soldier, which takes some quality rocket jumping. And this is just a really strong position for him to hold. A tactical visor up high can do a lot of work. And let's see if he can get knocked off by Huss on the Winston.
Yeah, he is going to try and knock him off, but I think he fell a little bit short. Jeff, though, taking that slither. Shrandy with that tactical visor, as you mentioned, did take down Hobbs, but Huss was right there with him, and he took him down immediately as Lush took down Tyranid. The revive has to come out from Numki, and as Lush got the double kill, this is just absolutely going the way of HKS. Armor taking down Huss just to try and keep things in their favor, and I think HKS actually going to back off.
And look at that, six ultimates all up at once here for HKS. This next push is going to be a very scary one, especially considering Numki's just used his revive. And unless they have a really protracted session of poking here, which they shouldn't because they've got six ults up, there's no point to poke. It's going to be very hard for the Q-Raiders to stop them coming in.
And that was actually really good from them, from HKS the last round, because what they did was they pushed in, they wasted a couple of the ultimates for the other team, and then they came back and said, now we've got six ultimates, and here they are. Although Tyranid with a massive Earth Shatter, he gets a couple, the Primal Rage has to come out. In the backline though, Slidshaw, he's going nuts on that Genji. Plus took down Tyranid, Pulse takes down Trandy, everyone's getting a kill for HKS. Lush gets the kill now, he takes down the Tyre, Armor taking down Funky. Oh, well, that was well executed, well synchronized. HKS are going to take this round 4-3 on Anubis.
Yeah, and as we discussed, the ult advantage you get from steamrolling them on that first point is everything. So 6 ults to 2, I think it was there on that last push. No revive. Numki did this, played it smart, you know, hid behind the in that little back room there and got the revive on the first push. But you know, they've nerfed how quickly Mercy can get her revive up, and you can't get it in the middle of a team fight if you just used it anymore. So they did well not to poke and feed her there, and that just, it made it a certainty almost that second push.
Well, Slisher was absolutely a menace on that Genji all game, and even when he DC'd, the team still went on and did really well. Bobby J, in the end, probably a victory that many saw coming.
Yeah, HKS, definitely moving on with the momentum now, advancing to 4-1 to join Kick or Get Kicked in Aftermind, also at 4-1 with Jam Gaming currently at 5-0. So it was a good game. Creators of the Meme Jam, they showed them some, they didn't give it up that easy, man. It was a pretty close game until right near the end. And it had that Maywall just broke their spirits. But what do you think of the game, Goma?
Yeah, I think that one of the things about 2CP is that you get these back and forths where it seems like a team's capping really fast, but actually that's pretty standard. And we saw that with both teams capping at about 3 to 4 minutes, I think it was. And they both just capped and kept back at each other. And I think both teams put up a good showing. It's just the HKS had that extra mile. We saw that sneaky Mei play. We saw Slid on Genji ripping things apart, and it's just, they just had that extra edge which got them over the line. But I think Curators played pretty well.
What about you, OG? What did you think of the game?
Yeah, I have to agree with Gaima there. Curators played quite a good game. I think the defining factor really in the end came down to just the experience shown by Lush and Slidzor. Slidzor just being able to play, you know, Junkrat, Mei when it needed to happen, and Genji as well. Just that knowledge to know, okay, they've only got this much time to push in. If I can go Mei and just split them up and basically turn into a 2v6, they've got no chance of coming in. So to make that instant swap under that much pressure is really helpful for the team. And confidence as well on the two control point maps, the assault maps, is extremely important as well, because there's such a, you know, usually on the second point, the respawn is so tough to, it's so short. So if you mess up your push, it can really be a little bit demoralizing, like having to walk all the way back and reset up and poke. So just having that confidence of knowing as soon as we got the first point, they're going to go in there and cap it, and you wait, as you said, wait for their ults to come up so they could chain them perfectly. I was just very impressed by HKS and Lush especially. Like, you can see why he was a very, very good DPS player on those previous teams. He knows how to play, you know, McCree and Tracer, and he just knows when to play them as well. So, yeah, great game by HKS, but yeah, Curators put out quite a good showing on that, I felt.
So congratulations to HKS getting the victory here in round number 5 of your GameStar E-League Overwatch qualifiers for the Spring Series. We'll be back very shortly with round number 6 here on GameStar TV1. We'll see you shortly.
And just before we sign off, ladies and gentlemen, and get ourselves ready for round number 6, we've hit 100 viewers for the qualifying tournament, and that means raffle time. And the requests have come through from the Twitch chat for a mug from Ronnie's custom gear. So we have put in an order with Ronnie for 30 mugs to give away during the regular season. We'll start with that now. If we go over the 30 because we're giving away today, hey, that's fine. We'll do 31 instead of 30. So here we go. We're going to open up the raffle in just a few moments. You will just have to type !! MUG for mug, and you'll be entered into the raffle. We'll be right back.